Hi everyone, it's Peter from PS Sound, and this is going to be a short, unusual video, shall we say, of a system. We shared a video of your car 2 years ago.
Yeah, 2019, I think.
Long time ago, yeah. When you had a system in it. I'm sure many people remember that, when you had a bigger racetrack. And now you rebuilt it for a bit more fun, because you were pissed off that whenever you go to a meeting, the car wasn't loud enough outside.
That's right, yeah.
So now you still have the sound coder system that we will go through, but you also have something crazy at the back, because this thing is, it will upset a few people. So let's see what you have now. It's still unfinished, but there's a lot happening. Let's show to people what's happening here at the back. You can explain. What was the idea behind it?
Just to be different this year than it was last year.
Okay.
So just to take it to another level and show people what it can do. I.e. everything moving. And just to show off, obviously, all the Steg.
That's brilliant. More gear underneath. And that's motorized as well. To wire this one up, yeah, that could have been a nightmare. To run cables underneath these moving panels. So, can you stop that? Or you have to take it down and
no,
then bring it back?
No, it just goes down.
Okay. Because I just wanted to explain what's what.
Yep.
Pull down the music a touch in the background, because we are already in a loud environment at your friend's workshop. A lot of steel machinery. Beautiful place. I would have fun here. Okay, let's just explain. So the system has two DSPs. There's a DSP Pro, a Helix DSP Pro, running the sound quality side. We will go through that inside of the cabin. But there's also a Steg DSP over there, used for this madness, running fully active. So that amplifier runs the tag gate, right? So two channels for the tweeters and two channels for the mids, which are running in parallel. So one channel for that side, one channel for these two. Then that Steg runs tweeters, mids, right?
Yep, wide bands and yep.
And then, you don't have tweeters inside, you have wide bands.
Yep.
And mid bass, whatever we could kicks, we show that. And then this 4-channel runs the underseat bass drivers and the rear fuel inside. Then there are two monoblocks as well from Steg, the SD1000 something. One of those each run a pair of 8-inch subs inside of the cabin. So we have 4 8-inch subs all together. And where's the DSP Pro? Underneath?
Underneath this one.
Underneath that hiding. Yeah. Okay. Because, it could have been, quite a challenge to wire everything up with all these moving things. It's still in progress. There's still a lot to do. Oh yes. We have to put yellow race song on. What about the other one? Is that running as well?
Just needs a little bit more
tweaking.
Running in. Yeah.
Okay. There you go. There's a bit of life there as well. Car wash. And what was that? What's that couple doing back there?
I think they're dogging.
It looks a bit like that. He's trying to pull something out of his trouser, Brilliant. What else? What else can we see?
Just like you would.
He's doing something there as well. Brilliant. So, you had fun with this system, building it in the last few months. Flashy lights. Oh yes, that's where we can see the subs inside. then if we go to the cabin, from here we can see the rear fuel coaxes, which run in two different ways. They can run as differential for the sound quality system inside, or we have a show preset where they play full range, full blast madness. Some of you may remember this system, although the video that we shared on YouTube 2 years ago, at the time you already had these, or didn't you?
Three focals,
or maybe you had the focals, I can't remember. So we have the hybrid L2 SEs, Y-bands. They play really, really nice tweeterless. The problem in this car is that you don't have pillars, you don't have pillar trims, nothing. So it's only 3D printed these, and you flog them. That's a ring, right?
Yep.
Hiding the mounting. Yep. Then you have focal, I think is the ES165K coax or whatever it is. But in this car, again, nothing can be cut. So that's just built onto the trim panel. So the airspace is tiny. So those drivers, even if they are 6.5, they can't play low at all. So when we were running through your options years ago, what you could have, then I said, you know what, let's use those as mid-bass but not playing bass, kind of like 150 upwards, and for that they are absolutely perfect to play up to like the 400 hertz range where the 2-inch comes in. And underneath the seats we have, can we see those actually here?
I'm not sure.
Oh no, I can't reach it, so we can't see it. But we have the Focal iSub Twin, one on each side, and they play, depending on the preset, they play between 60 and 160, or on the party mode tune they play from 80 up to 160, then the kicks and the Y bands. So that's how the freeway comes together. So the director runs the SQ system, and then the Steg DSP runs the tag gate. But the signal from the source is split for the two separate systems. So the front output from the head unit goes to the Helix DSP Pro, right?
Yep.
And the rear goes to the Steg DSP. And the sub output runs to the Helix as well, routed to the subs. So that's how you can still have control over the head unit. Yeah, you have many controllers now. It's a bit complex, and that's where the subs are. Still unfinished, because it has to be decided whether you put the seat in or not. If not, then that section down there where you can see the wood, that's gonna be covered. But that's the thing, most of the times we show fully finished builds, and then most owners wouldn't even be happy to show their work in progress, because they say, oh, it doesn't look right yet, it still needs so much time. But there's nothing wrong with that. It actually inspires everyone to, you know, get out of the house, stop watching crap on Netflix, and then rather start building your systems if you enjoy music and if you want to have the freedom to play nice music. Now you will definitely be able to play loud outside. There you go, Steg -4, and it's freaking loud, that's for sure. What preset do we have on now? So there's the show preset, there's a sound quality preset, and the sound quality loud when the system can take a bit more beating on the occasion when you drive. But yeah, show is the one that has full output and everything. Even in on this preset, the coax plays full range all the way up. It's not crossed on the 400 hertz. So yeah, we have everything blasting, right? So this is your little baby, and they can find you there on Instagram, correct?
Yep.
Because you go to many meetings.
Yes.
And then people can see this mad project in this rare car. Just so we mention it in this video as well, what can people know about the car? Because you have spent many years on it, right?
She's running 2.1 ZVH turbo engine.
Open up on it. Pop the hood! Come on. Because
a one-off on it.
Yep.
It was machined on there.
That's a proper laser cutter. There are crazy things here. Benders, cutters. Lovely place. Yep. Okay, carry on. There you go.
She needs a bit of a tidy up.
You can, you can explain.
Yeah, but the next phase will be to tidy this bit up. She's running full gas coilovers, fully adjustable all the way around, with RS rims, which are super rare as well.
You collected everything throughout the years.
Yeah, everything really, you know. It's
I'm gonna shut the door, then people can see it from the side. There you go.
You can see how she looks.
Because even if you've had this car for years and you've done many mods to it,
yeah,
this bonnet is one off. Even if you've had it for years, you mentioned that you may part with.
Yeah, might be going up for sale this year and the right price, and then it'll be a project for you rather than me.
Audio wise.
Yeah.
No. Yeah, I know you will do a lot to the car itself, but yeah, but that's the thing.
That's the last one I'm building.
No. There's no such thing. You're too young for that, saying that. But fair enough, you mentioned your dream.
Yeah, it's to really go into Emma, and I want a car that I can take to Europe. This is too precious to drive abroad.
You could, but we know there are so many things with old cars that can go wrong, and then you don't want to stay on the side of the road. But at the same time, this is something special, you know, especially now when the electric car era is coming. Well, it's already here. Old beauties like this are getting more and more rare, and especially for the old generation, it means so much more. Nobody really, well, I mean, yes, people care about the sound system, and good music on a show is always great, but at the same time, I know that some people don't care about the music at all. They just want to see the car. They want to see all the mods that you've done to it, because it brings back memories. All the memories from the era when...
Yeah, the 80s, the 90s.
Yeah, people were going crazy.
Yeah.
On
Max
the roads,
paradise.
Exactly. But now it's more complete, and definitely worthy taking her to your show and playing nice music loud as well.
Loud, I don't know for it.
I don't even know how he's gonna come through the video, because in person when it's turned up, okay, the bass cannot keep up with this Tag 8. That's for sure. That was never the intention. Yeah, especially when people realize what alternator you can fit in this car. Is a tiny alternator,
yeah,
so
75 amp
having big bass in these cars is difficult unless you have a lot of battery power, but then you don't want to put so much weight into it. Having said that, now you have just upgraded to lithium. It's worth mentioning for the guys who are into audio. You have proper Victron lithium battery with lithium charger, with app and everything.
Yeah. So, battery on that side is 100 amp.
Yeah, it's hiding in there now.
Battery underneath there.
What's the battery brand? What is it? Where is it from?
It's from a company I can't think of the top of my head. I got it as a kid. So I got that and the Electron Energy charger.
There you go.
To charge it, and obviously then I've also got another bank that sits on behind there that charges from the front battery to the rear battery, but all via Bluetooth.
Yep.
And then it
kind of like a regulator to not to put all the load a lithium battery can introduce to an alternator, so that regulator keeps the load constant.
Yeah. And I mean she's sitting at 13 amps now, so
yep.
Constant.
Yeah, whereas before you had major problems with
the voltage in the car. Yeah, it would wear down so much. This lasts forever.
Yeah, with your previous system, I remember we played two songs and you were down below 12 volt.
Yeah, especially running all this in the back as well. You know what I mean? What, lights. I had the track and everything.
Yep. Indeed. Well, I had to kick you a bit to invest into lithium, because that's not the future, that's the present. Lithium batteries are so much cheaper than what they were like. When I bought my 60 amp hour lithium, that was £800 four or five years ago. Now you can get one of those for like half of it.
Yeah.
So it's not that expensive anymore. Cool, so this is where we are going to leave this video. In description you can find a link to, I'm going to link in your profile.
Yeah.
So then people can find you, and you always share when you go to a meeting, they can see you.
Yeah.
Where are you going tomorrow? Well, if I share this tonight, then it's relevant. Otherwise it's not relevant.
There's a place called North World in Essex.
Okay.
It's just a nice coffee morning, really, you know, there's a good few people. A whole selection of cars. So that'll be its sort of first one, and then it'll be at the British Museum, Car Museum, on I think the 2nd of May at a show. And that's where it'll be showing there as well. Now it's tuned.
It's tuned time.
Tuned.
Now it's tuned, now it plays nice. All right, this is where we finish this video, guys. Hopefully you liked it. You got a bit of inspiration to get your project going. And who knows, what else I can share with people. Well, I haven't mentioned to people yet. I'm going to a nice show soon where I will have many fancy cars I can take footage of, and then you can see what's happening in Europe. And I have to find free time to share our projects, because we've had so much work lately that I can't even keep up to to share all of that. But for this one, this is it, guys. Hope you liked it. Subscribe to the channel, all the usual things. Thanks for showing this to us.
Thank you, Peter.
And then we'll see you in the next one. Take care. When we were the light, you would just call me more. We've been talking a lot, saying we were child, saying that you won't. Thank you.
Everything happens for a reason, to make us stronger.